Hey there guys, welcome back to my channel, and in this video we are going to see how to make a virtual hand keyboard. So let's start. So right over here you can see that I have here an app. When I press, so it just types that letter, so you can see that it works fine. So let's see how to make it. I will just exit this, and what I will just do is go to my previous hand tracking code which I had, so you must remember it. So I will also give the tutorial and the source code link in the description, and you will also get the source code link of the AI virtual keyboard project which we are making right now. So let's see. So let's import our imports. I will import map, and I will use a new module called py input for keyboard controlling. I will see here from py input import controller, and I will also import the key. Now let's just import the controller. And now what I will just do is I will also add here the time.sleep, so I should get an purple. So that's why I will import time. And what I will just do before starting, I have here a variable list for the keys. So I will just paste this. You will also get this list in my description. So in this are basic keys which I need, and a list, and we have sub list for rows and columns. And now what I will just do is create here class for storing the data which I used for drawing the keys. Here I will create a store class, and here I will define an init function, something like that. And inside this init function, what I will just do is I will say here self dot. So first let's ask it for our arguments, and the arguments are position, and then the size, and then the text. So let's define them. So I will say here position equals to position which you have, and then the self dot size equals to size we have, and then self dot text equals to the text we have. So just below it, what I will just do, now we have our store function. So I will also create a function for drawing. I'll say here define draw, and inside this function what I will just do is ask it for my image and this stored mass. And then just below it, what I will just do is say here for var in stored var. And what I will just do inside this, I will say here var dot position, and I will just set it as x and y, and I will say here the width and height as var dot size, something like that. And what I will just do to draw the rectangle here, I will say cv2 dot rectangle means the button which we will draw and put text on it. Here I will say here image, and then I will say here button dot position. And then what I will just do is say here my x, y plus width height. And here also similarly. And then what we need is the color. So the color will be a grayish color, which will be 64x64. And for the thickness, I will say fill. And just below it, I will also put the text for the button. And here what I will just do is say here image. And then here I will say button.text. Actually, I will put var.text. and here I will set the x and y as x plus 10 and y plus, and let's add here 43. So I have just tested these parameters before, and what I will just do after adding the x and y, here I will set the font as Hershey plain, and let's keep the scale at 3 and then the color as white. And then the thickness as 2, right? And here what I will just do, return my image after drawing it. So that just wraps up the draw function. And what I will just do is create here and store draw. And what I will just do just below it, I will see here for I in range of the from, so it will be the length of the keys, and just inside it what I will just do is see here for J and the key, and this will be in enumerate, and here I will say the key and I will access the I, right? So now what we will get is the index of the element and the keys. So what I will just do, let's say here store dot append, and inside this what I am going to append is my, here I will say, I will call my store function. And inside this what I will say is, here will say 60 as and multiplied by, so what I will just do is wrap this in the as a list, and here will say multiplied by J, will say plus 10, and here as the y will be 60 multiplied by I plus, and this time I will say plus 10 also. And for the size, it will be 50 by 50. And then the text will be the key that we have. And now what we should get is the stored var. So now what I will just do after getting the stored var is just below it, I will first, let's get the lm list. Here we will say lm list equals blank. So to get the lm list, what I have to just do, right over here will say for id and the element and enumerate. So I will just copy this results.multi-landmarks and paste it in this enumerate. Here I will say the first index and here I will say dot landmark, right? And just over here what I will just do, so 0 means the first hand that we have. He will say h height width and then the channel, and he will say image dot shape. So right over here, after getting the shape, I will also get the center x and center y, and those both will be integer. Here I will say lm dot x multiplied by width, okay, multiplied by width, and similarly here, just after that, I will just copy this all and paste it, and here will say multiplied by height, here will say y, right? And what I will just do is say here lm list dot append, and inside this I will append my cx and cy, right? And after this here will check that if the lm list, so first let's draw it. Here will say just and over here I will say image equals to draw. I will call this function, here will specify my image, here will say stored vars, right? So now if I try this code out, so now what I will just do here, just use. So let's delete this previous main.py file which I had. Or let's keep it. So now if I run this, so now you will be able to see this. And now actually I have run the wrong file. Yeah. So now here I have it. So now here you should be able to see something like this. So actually I am writing the wrong code which I have. So the file, so what I will just do is delete this file. And what I will just do is rename this into the main.py. I will save this code and now if I try out. So this file is main. And now you should be able, so here we get an error. Cannot import this. The problem here was I was importing the store one from my previous one. So here I will change this name itself to store one. And now if I try it, now it should not be getting that error. So here I get here an error for this. I have to say here dot keyboard. Okay. And now if I try this, it should work. And to press enter, we need to see. So now you will be able to see. Now we have these keys drawing. Now if I close this. Right. So to make the main functionality, here what I will just do is come over here. And I will just say here, if lm list is not blank, then only what you can just do, come over here. And inside this, get your var in the stored var list. And just what I will just do is check here my here let's define our x and y first, and here also let's define our width and height as var dot size, right? And here what I will just do is run here an if condition. If the x is less than greater than sign lm list, so the pointing finger which we have here, I will say 8th finger as the index. Here I will say 0 and here I will say greater than less than sign x plus width. And so here it tells us to y less than greater than lm list. And here also I will say 8th element and here I will say 0. And what I will just say is less than greater than x plus height. Actually here will be y plus height. Means we are checking that we are on that rectangle. So if I bring my index finger on that rectangle, then what I will do is show that I am on that, I am pointing at that rectangle. So here also what I will say is rectangle, and here I will say image, and here I will say x and y, and x plus width, then y plus height. And here what I will just do is say here plus 5. So here say plus 5, plus 5, and here also I say minus 5, and here also I will say minus 5. And here what I will just do is show the color as red, and this time the thickness will be as filled. And what I will just do is see how to get the length. So to get the length, here I will define my x1 and the y1 as lm list 8th element, and here I will define my x2 and y2 as my lm list 12th element. To calculate the distance, what I will just do is use my math.hypot, and inside this math.hypot, what I will just do, we need to specify two arguments, x2 minus x1, and here we'll say minus 30, and similarly here we'll say y2 minus y1 minus 30. So we will get the distance between those both finger. We'll say print l, and here we'll add the condition for the when click. So first let's check our proper distance. I will save it and there we go. So now let's check it, what we have. Yes. So whenever I click this, hold on a moment. So here we have an issue. Okay, now it's good. Yes. Right, so whenever I click, so it's between 63, so it's less, so it's, I'll just come over here, I'll say here, if not, so let me just close this, right, so here I will say, if not, and here what I will just do is say here, if not, the L here will say greater than or less than 63, then means it's clicked. And when I click, what I have to do, let's see here. So here I will use my pi input. Here I will say keyboard equals to, so here we'll say controller. And what I will just do is come over here, and here we'll say keyboard dot press, and here what I will just do, also draw that rectangle. When I press, I will also draw that rectangle in the color of green. So now we have almost made this project. So what I will just do in the keyboard dot press, here I will say var dot text, and here if you want to press enter, you can use if condition and say here from pi input dot keyboard, you can import the key, and here you can say key dot enter. So I will just go with this, and just below it I will use my time dot sleep at last, and here I will sleep it for 0.15 seconds as the float. Right, so now we have made this, so let's test it out. I will just open my notepad right over there, and now let's try this out. So let's give it a try.